Welcome to Linda's TV show. If it is your first time of stopping by and you like this program, please do not hesitate to subscribe and you turn on your notification bell. That is very, very important as it will enable you to know when I upload a new video. I present to you information about what is happening in the whole world, Nigeria to be precise. You are free to leave your comment constructively after watching each of my video. Please do it judiciously. I appreciate all of you. It's not easy for you to leave whatever you are doing to watch my program. May God Almighty bless you, because I do not have anything to give to you as we hop into today's video. Remain blessed.
We are them, and they will crush them. That's my take about that particular one.
Now they are going to roll a 5,000 Fulani vigilantes as counter in 36 days.
It's not possible. Are you saying that in all local government we have 5,000 people in each local government, which is not actually true? It is not true. All what they are just saying, I'm still saying it. They are afraid. They are what? They are afraid. How many are Fulanis?
Almost 5% of the population.
They are not 5% of the population. So what they are just saying, they are just making mouth. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make anything. Like that of fear grips Oba. They went to kidnap an Oba in his palace. My brothers and sisters, it has started. They are gradually kidnapping the rich. They are gradually kidnapping the high net people. Because of what? They fail to tell the truth. They fail to address the issue that we are having. Rather, they are supporting what they are not supposed to support. If care is not taken, the governors, the senators will be next in line, because they will begin to kidnap them. That is when they will now come to their real senses and say, let us tackle this menace. I see said, they are not bandits, they are terrorists. The government in power know them. They should fish them out. If they fish them out, Nigeria will be a better place to live. And the so-called agitation of the Oduduwa Republic, the IPOB, all those things will die naturally. If the governors, the senators, come out to say the truth, all those agitation will die naturally. That's my take about that.
Okay, thank you very much, sir, for your wonderful analysis this morning. We have Mr. Matthew. Mr. Matthew, good morning.
Good morning.
Miyeti Allah have come to say that Ebube Ago and Amotek won't stop them. What are the things that they are doing that they are saying they won't stop them?
I think the mentality of Miyeti Allah speaks to an organization that run with impunity. By all standards, if you are an organization recognized by Nigerian law, it is not sufficient for you to start threatening other Nigerians. We have seen in the past where even the government itself tried to play as if the spokesman or spokesperson for the Miyeti Allah. I think the government has somewhat tolerated Miyeti Allah, especially under this administration. Because by our standard, the excesses of the Fulani henchmen we are seeing, the Miyeti Allah's position is even the one encouraging them. Because I've never seen any time Miyeti Allah will come out to condemn nefarious activities being perpetrated by herders across board in this country. They maim people, they kill people, they rape women, they destroy crop, and all this, you don't see Miyeti Allah coming out to condemn these activities. So what I'm saying is, it is evident that Fulani henchmen globally, they are terrorist organization.
Like the United Nations.
The global terrorism, they say that Fulani henchmen, that they are the fourth most dangerous terrorist organization in the world. So to that extent, I think if the government of Nigeria is serious to address the myriad of security challenges, they should know the step to take and they should know where to go to. Because the situation where you are having so many people kidnapped on daily basis, Look at what is happening in Kaduna State. Look at what is happening in Zamfara. Look at what Gumi is saying, that federal government should give bandits amnesty. On what basis? These are criminals who have no justification to take to arm. And they want to force the country to start giving them funds through amnesty. And we have seen in the past where the government have blamed the influx of Fulani into Nigeria as a result of the crisis in Libya. We have seen in the past where a Ganduje have said that to stop this clashing between herders and whole communities, that there's every need to stop Fulani movement from Libya, from Niger, from Burkina Faso, from neighboring African countries into Nigeria. And these are people who are crude in nature. They have no respect for Eastern laws. I'm not saying every Fulani man is a criminal. I'm not saying the Fulani man should not do his or her legitimate business. We have seen in the past where Fulani herdsmen move about. They are nomadic in nature, so they move about doing their business. But it's unfortunate that the modern Fulani who have infiltrated into the ranks of the traditional Fulani have end up giving all the Fulani a bad name. The way it stands, a Fulani, that name Fulani, have been stigmatized in Nigeria. It doesn't matter how you look at it. Apart from some few persons in the north, every other Nigerian is united against Fulani. Because look at, it's not just about Fulani terrorism. Because the way it stands, it's unfortunate anyway, there's that stigmatization when it comes to Fulani. I'll tell you something. Federal government have tried to do Ruga. Why is it that in spite of the whole value chain attached to that livestock program, no state is willing, especially in the south, is willing to sign on and provide land for Ruga to take off. Look at the popular livestock transformation program, already consummated and signed by the 36 governors. Tell me any south governor that the way it stands today that will volunteer land for that program. To be quite honest with you, cattle rearing is a good business. But the way they have done it, and the way it's being driven by Fulani nationality, no governor, no traditional ruler, no landowner in the south will be willing to volunteer land for either Ruga, that National Livestock Transformation Program, or any other program that want to advance the livestock program when it comes to do with rearing of cow. And it's unfortunate. So what I'm saying is, what the government needed to do is to profile the bad eggs.
That's Mietiala.
Not just the Mietiala.
Because now Amoteku and these people are good, they are fighting insecurity. And if a Mietiala will say that they won't stop us, that means they are the ones fomenting the trouble.
Okay, now look at this. Amoteku and Ebago, they are child of circumstance. The situation necessitated it. So if there were no killing, there were no clashes between herders and those communities, and if government were addressing this insecurity as and when due, Amoteku, there would not be need for Amoteku. There will not be need for a bago. No, the bago of a thing for me is just in principle, it's not in practice. The government of the southeastern states, they just want to be in the good book of the federal government. That is why they are coming up with that bag of a thing. I don't see them operating. Because in the southeast, the governors are like working as opposition to the people. Bible said that. I think what is pertinent at this point is for the government to live above board. I think the government, the way it's been driven, there's every that sense of these people are Mr. President's people. As such, you handle their issue with levity. But a good leader, what a good leader does is, in respect of who owes it God, you rise above your parochial interests. You handle issues based on, because of the interests of Nigerians generally. I could remind you, under Obasanjo, when OPC SSS was threatening the corporate existence of Nigeria, Obasanjo at the time arrested their leader. And he was kept in prison. Even as weak as Jonathan, like people want.
Deep in the shadow. Hi, welcome to my channel. If this is your first time or first day of coming across my YouTube channel or seeing my face, you are highly welcome. Please be comments to my next channel. My name is Linda Chukwueze. It comes as Miguel. Click on that red button that says subscribe and you turn on the notification bell so that you'll be able to get information on the
bis zum nächsten Video und einen schönen Tag. Tschüss.
Tschüss. Bis man subscribe to Linda's TV show. What are you waiting for? Click on that red button that says subscribe. You turn on the notification bell so that you'll be getting more updates from me. Leave your comment down below and share this video with your friends, families, and colleagues until we meet again in my next video. Bye bye.